City Montessori School, Lucknow organized 22nd International Conference of Chief Justices of the World on Article 51 of the Constitution of India, Global Peace Congress 2021, online is an earnest appeal to the United World Judiciary to safeguard the future of world's children, as it is the school's belief that the United World Judiciary is the last hope of humanity's survival. Dear parents and guardians of the world, arise, awake, and unite.
Dear friends, we are holding this conference on Article 51 of the Constitution of India. Last year it was online, and this year also we are having this conference online. We want to save the life of not only 2.5 billion children in the world, but of the total 7.5 billion people of this world. This is only possible when the world is united. So, dear friends, there is a peace, then there is a prosperity. Unity, if there is unity, there is prosperity. So, we want to unite the world in the name of children, and because of the fact that this is such a good mission that so many chief justices and judges are participating. In this conference, 51 countries are participating. Honorable Hridayanand Dikshitji, Speaker of Uttar Pradesh Legislative Assembly, Mr. Nitin Agarwal, Deputy Speaker of the Legislative Assembly of Uttar Pradesh, Honorable Shri Rajnath Singh, Shri Kalnath Mishra, Dinesh Sharma Ji, Keshav Prasad Maurya, Deputy Chief Minister, Brijesh Pathak, Minister for Law and Justice, Sankta Bhatia, Mayor of Lucknow. I welcome all of you for gracing this occasion and attending this conference.
The essence of CMS education to teach students and the larger diverse audience the oneness of God, unity of humankind, universal brotherhood, world unity and world peace through all religions prayer. World unity prayer. And conducting World Parliament was beautifully propagated online by the students of CMS.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have all gathered here today to discuss on the agenda at hand and devise solutions to global issues. The delegates here shall be discussing on reviewing the UN Charter to make international law universally enforceable by establishing a World Parliament.
Delegate of Iraq, Delegate of USA, Delegate of Bangladesh, Delegate of UK, Delegate of France, Delegate of Iran, and Delegate of Australia. Delegate of Iraq, you have been recognized.
Peace cannot be sustained by force. It can only be achieved by understanding.
The United Nations has kept war at bay since 1945. But now the times are changing, and we must act before it's too late.
Respect for international laws has always played a key role in my country's work. However, there are several examples in international affairs of unresolved disputes and breaches of international laws that are never formally adjudicated.
Australia is a peace-loving country, and we have always tried and we always will make efforts towards achieving sound international relations and a better society.
We conclude this session with immense hope and wishes for a more just, peaceful and harmonious world.
The need for an international forum of chief justices and judges. What is the need for such a forum? We know that the world is in travail. It needs remedies for today's problems. I think you will agree with me that one of the most important trends in the world, probably the most important global trend, is a growing sense of the shared problems that humanity faces together. Climate change, the deniers of climate change have ample evidence today that it is not required to deny science anymore. It is not possible to deny that. It poses an existential threat to humanity. The COVID pandemic has exposed global health challenges. COVID pandemic has led to a realization that even the rich are only as strong as the weakest link that exists. Everybody must flourish in order for anybody to flourish. In the public consciousness, these developments have heightened this awareness.
It gives me great pleasure to invite and present before you the message of acceptance by Honorable Mr. Justice Pekhi Mafalala, Chief Justice of the Superior Court of Judicature, Eswatini, who has been awarded the key to the city of Lucknow on behalf of citizens of Lucknow by Mrs. Sayukta Bhatia, the Mayor of Lucknow.
Honorable Mr. Justice Pekhi Mafalala has already attended International Conference of Chief Justice of the World organized by CMS in the year 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020 and 2021.
I'd love to thank the convener and founder. I'd love to thank the convener and founder manager of CMS, the president and the managing director of CMS, the management of CMS, the honorable mayor and management of the city Lucknow. I accept the award with humility on behalf of the world community who believe in the ideals and values for which CMS stands.
We have a very spirited song, which you'll be surprised has been sung with, you know, that die-hard spirit, lot of enthusiasm by the members of City Montessori School Management and the music teachers of City Montessori School. Keep.
Find the words that matter, say them out loud, and make it better somehow. Looking down from up on the moon, it's a tiny blue marble. Who would have thought the ground we stand on could be so fragile? This is a love song to the earth.
शांति अमन और प्रेम की ज्योति से ज्योति जलाते जाएंगे. One world, one family. It's one world, one family. It's one world, one family. Vasudeva Kutumbakam. Vasudeva Kutumbakam.
That was beautiful. That was really awesome, wasn't it, ladies and gentlemen? Time now for us to listen to our Honourable Chief Guest, Honourable Mr. Rajnath Singh Ji, Minister of Defence, Government of India.
My dear brothers and sisters, firstly, I would like to congratulate the management, teachers, students, and specifically the founder manager of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhiji. It is always an enriching experience to see the confluence of ideas emanating from different countries and cultures. India is known for unity in diversity, pluralistic ethos, and peaceful coexistence of all religions, cultures, and beliefs. And it is manifested in our age-old belief of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. It reflects our core commitment to ensuring world peace and brotherhood.
Time now for me to invite the youngest member of the management of City Montessori School, the Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Roshan Gandhi Farooqi, for proposing the vote of thanks.
I'd like to thank all of the eminent participants and guests from all over the world who have given their precious time to be with us this evening and will continue to do so over the next few days. Heads of state, chief justices of supreme courts, legal luminaries, and other eminent guests who have very kindly chosen to be with us and to enlighten us with their gracious thoughts. For the ceremony and all of the incredible presentations that we've seen, a huge debt of thanks is owed to the Kanpur Road campus of City Montessori School, headed by the indomitable Dr. Vinita Kamran and her amazing team. Thanks to Dr. Kamran, the teachers, and the students of Kanpur Road campus for the wonderful plethora of cultural presentations.
School as the lighthouse of society, CMS is leaving no stone unturned to ideate for a new and effective one world order. It may be a long road, but the most powerful weapon of the world, that is the vision of ancient Indian philosophy of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam and Jai Jagat, its time has arrived for the world to use it to tackle every world affairs. Here is Sri Rajnath Singh.
The world in the recent past has been marked by numerous upheavals, eradication of old lifestyles and values, and the collapse of many once honored institutions. COVID-19 has brought in fear, anxiety, and depression, and has posed a new urgency for global coordination. Member Nation Afghanistan, you're recognized.
Madam Speaker, it is unfortunate that even in these times of crisis, narrow sovereign interests govern international conduct.
Global institutions are not working well, individually and as a group, because of being fragmented.
We need to find ways and means through multilateralism to propel the world into a sharper and proactive trajectory that makes full use of modern science and technology for the benefit of all the children of the world.
It was a wonderful World Parliament by CMS Gomti Nagar 1 and wonderful Model United Nations by CMS Rajajipuram 1. I congratulate Abha Anand Didiji and respected Nisha Didiji for their wonderful presentations.
Uttar Pradesh ke Mukhyamantri Manani Yogi Adityanath ji ka Mukhya Atithi ke roop mein hum hardik swagat karte hain.
I would like to tell you, the friends, that our Chief Minister has done a lot of good work, and this state of Uttar Pradesh, where we are having this conference, has become the first state in India in everything.
And he said that it is the moral duty of all of us to provide a safe world for the children, and that this effort of City Montessori School to work for the welfare, well-being, and flourishing of children, the 2.5 billion children of the world, is the fact that CMS has taken upon itself the duty to work towards improving the well-being of children throughout the world is a very it's a very wonderful effort of CMS, and he appreciates it wholeheartedly, and he sends his very best wishes to this conference. Thank you.
Let us not delay any further and also listen to the First Lady of our city, Honorable Mrs. Sanyukta Bhatia, the Mayor of Lucknow, as she comes on this platform to remind us, the citizens of the city and also the people who are listening from across the world, that we carry on our shoulders the responsibility of bringing about a change in the fortunes of the world. Over to you, ma'am.
सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल लखनऊ के द्वारा विश्व के मुख्य न्यायाधीशों के 22वें अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन में ऑनलाइन प्रतिभाग कर रहे देश विदेश के सम्मानित प्रतिनिधियों का मैं भारत के सबसे बड़े राज्य उत्तर प्रदेश की राजधानी लखनऊ की मेयर के रूप में हार्दिक स्वागत एवं अभिनंदन करती हूँ। सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल के संस्थापक डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी जी, डॉक्टर भारती गांधी जी को हार्दिक बधाई देती हूँ, जिनके द्वारा ये अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन आयोजित किया गया है। उन्होंने वैश्विक कोरोना महामारी की चुनौतियों के बीच में भी ऑनलाइन के माध्यम से आप सभी को एक विश्व मंच पर इकट्ठा होने का अवसर प्रदान किया है। इस आयोजन में जहां विश्व भर के प्रतिष्ठित सभी को एक मंच प्राप्त होगा, वहीं यहां हुई चर्चा से विश्व के लिए सार्थक परिणाम भी निकलेंगे और यह विश्व बंधुत्व के लिए एक सार्थक पहल साबित होगी। इसके लिए मैं CMS संस्थापक डॉक्टर जगदीश गांधी जी एवं डॉक्टर भारती गांधी जी को पुनः एक बार हार्दिक बधाइयां और आभार प्रकट करती हूँ। हमारे देश की संस्कृति एवं सभ्यता ही वसुधैव कुटुंबकम की रही है, जिसमें हम संपूर्ण पृथ्वी को अपना घर और इसके समस्त मानव जाति को अपने परिवार का सदस्य मानते हैं। ऐसे में हमारा यह नैतिक कर्तव्य बनता है कि हम सारे विश्व की सारी मानव जाति की भलाई के लिए मिलकर काम करें। हमारे माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी का लगातार अपनी विश्वव्यापी एवं सकारात्मक कोशिशों के द्वारा संसार भर के देशों को एकता की डोर में बांधने के लिए प्रयास कर रहे हैं। ऐसे समय जब पूरा विश्व कोरोना महामारी की चपेट में था, हमारे प्रधानमंत्री आदरणीय नरेंद्र मोदी जी द्वारा देशवासियों को कोरोना महामारी से बचाने के लिए जो सार्थक कदम उठाए गए, उसकी मैं भूरी भूरी प्रशंसा करती हूँ। माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने देशवासियों के लिए ही नहीं अपितु भारत में निर्मित कोरोना की वैक्सीन को विश्व में निर्यात भी किया, जिसके लिए हम माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी का आभार जताते हैं। मैं विश्व भर की मानवता, विशेषकर विश्व के 2.5 अरब बच्चों के साथ ही आगे जन्म लेने वाली पीढ़ियों को एक सुंदर एवं सुरक्षित भविष्य प्रदान करने के लिए सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल लखनऊ द्वारा आयोजित किए जाने वाले इस अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन की अभूतपूर्व सफलता की कामना करती हूँ। मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आने वाले समय में एक नई विश्व व्यवस्था के निर्माण में यह अंतर्राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन अपनी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका को अवश्य निभाएगा। इन्हीं शुभकामनाओं के साथ जय हिंद, जय भारत।
थैंक यू सो मच मैम फॉर दैट वंडरफुल मैसेज, द कन्विक्शन दैट यू हैव, द ट्रस्ट दैट यू हैव, द फेथ दैट यू हैव इन द चिल्ड्रन ऑफ सिटी मॉन्टेसरी स्कूल, दैट दे वुड बी केपेबल इनफ and that they'll enable themselves to bring about a difference in this planet. Thank you so very much. Time